Now, next problem is also a good problem as it involves the use of some tricks. We are given that if alpha, beta, and gamma are cube roots of p, p is a negative number, then we need to find the value of x alpha plus y beta plus z gamma upon x beta plus y gamma plus z alpha, no matter what are the values of x, y, and z. Now, since alpha, beta, and gamma are the cube roots of p and p is a negative number, so let us assume p is equal to minus q. Q is greater than 0. So, p power 1 by 3 is equal to minus q times 1 by 3, which is equal to minus q times 1 by 3 into 1 power 1 by 3. And we know that 1 power 1 by 3 are having the values or the roots 1, omega and omega square. These three are the cube roots of unity. So, alpha can be written as minus q power 1 by 3 into 1. Beta can be written as minus q power 1 by 3 into omega. And gamma can be written as minus q times q power 1 by 3 into omega square. We are substituting the cube root of unity, the three roots, in the three given roots of p. Now, we need to just put the values of alpha, beta and gamma over here. The expression was x alpha plus y beta plus z gamma upon x beta plus y gamma plus z alpha. Now, putting alpha, beta and gamma over here, we get x into minus q power 1 by 3 plus y into minus q power 1 by 3 into omega plus z into minus q power 1 by 3 into omega square upon x into minus q power 1 by 3 into omega plus y into minus q power 1 by 3 into omega square plus z into minus q power 1 by 3. This minus q power 1 by 3 will get cancelled from the numerator and denominator, and we get x plus y omega plus z omega square upon x omega plus y omega square plus z, where omega and omega square are the cube roots of unity. Now, we see that if we multiply the numerator and denominator by omega square, we get x omega into omega square, which is x omega cube, and we know that omega cube is equal to 1. So, keeping the numerator as it is, we multiply this omega square with the denominator. This is x omega cube, which is x. This is y omega power 4. Omega cube is 1, so omega power 4 is equal to omega. So, this becomes y omega plus this becomes z omega square. We can very clearly see that these two terms get cancelled out and we get the answer as omega square. So, no matter what are the values of x, y and z, we get our final answer of the expression as omega square, where omega is the cube root of unity.